I don't know when I've had such a delicious meal.
Is everything all right there?
Oh, it's just a little quirk of mine. I like to keep things straight. You know, in parallel lines.
Yes, I noticed that earlier with the asparagus.
It's weird, I know. It used to drive my mother crazy.
Well, you know, we all have our little idiosyncrasies.
And do you have a little idiosyncrasy? That's from Frasier. And I can remember that when I would feel really anxious at times and feel like I was just overwhelmed with schoolwork, sometimes I would need my pens to be in the right order, in the right direction. And when I recognized that I was doing this and realized that it didn't take my overload away, you know, what was it accomplishing? I decided very early on that I was going to resist that. I wasn't going to play that game. That's the way I had held it in my own head. That my pens could be any which way because it wasn't going to change the overload. If I had overload, I had to deal with prioritizing what could give, what was my top priority, and how could I make it so that I wasn't flooded with all of the different tasks. You know, I was rearing kids. And I mean, the last thing I need to do is worry about my pencils being in order, right? Anyway, if you have quirks that you want to address, you can give me a call. My name's Dr. Ellen Kenner. The show is The Rational Basis of Happiness. And I can answer any questions you have on romance, problems with a coworker, problems with yourself, like those quirks, or problems with your kids, maybe. My kids are grown at this point, but I have grandkids, which is wonderful. Maybe problems with your grandkids or worries about them, or maybe you have caretaker responsibilities. Maybe just romance problems. I wrote a book with Dr. Ed Locke on how to value yourself in a romantic relationship. Pick up the phone and give me a call. My number is toll free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. That's toll free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. And now let's go to our after hours line.
Dr. Kenner, my question is this. My husband of 5 years has recently taken a job that causes him to be out of town 5 days a week. It's a fabulous job and he loves it very much, but I can't seem to cope with the fact that he's out of town. All I do is cry. I'm completely unproductive. I hate being away from him, and I know it's selfish, but at the same time, I can't make myself get over it. I don't know what to do.
So the first thing, when I hear you talking about this, I can hear how sad you are. I can hear that it feels uncontrollable. And the first thing you need to do is have enormous empathy for yourself, that this is a major change. And you're not both experiencing this exciting moment in his life equally. It's like having a kid graduate and the kid's so excited to go off to college and you're so sad because you're going to miss your child. So your husband's not leaving like a child would. Your husband's going to be coming back on weekends if he's gone 5 days a week. But still, I would be devastated myself if my husband were to leave 5 days a week. You know, he got a fabulous job. Okay, so he's all excited about his life. And now what do I do with my life? So the first clue that you have is your tears, these uncontrollable tears. I would get some paper out and a pen and just let those tears speak. If my tears could speak, what would they say? And initially you might say, I don't know, but then you might say, I feel so alone. I miss his touch. I miss having him next to me in bed. For 5 years we've been together. I miss that rhythm of our days. I have no one to share my thoughts with during the day. Whatever the thoughts are, you pull them out of your head uncensored. And you might say, this is not what I was thinking our marriage would be like. And he's so happy about it. And I don't think I could take this for a long time. And I wanted to start a family, and how are we going to do it? Because even if I did get pregnant on some weekend when he's home, I'm not going to have him with me during the week for that excitement of starting a family and the support. And it just makes me feel very empty. So you need to get all those types of thoughts out in the open, and you need to mourn the loss. You need to respect it. It's a grief process, that the rhythm of your days, the way they were, won't be the same going forward if he's loves this job. And if you try to say you can't keep this job, you know, you're going to become a source of guilt for him, and that's not going to do much for the relationship. And you could ask yourself some introspective questions too, which is like, what does his accepting this job say about him? You know, he's excited about you. You know, what does it say about me? Is there a self-esteem issue, maybe some abandonment issues, or just a drastic change in life? And what does it say about your life together? You may be thinking, maybe I'm not important enough that he can take this job. So if you're having some doubts, like maybe he doesn't trust me, or maybe he doesn't love me, maybe you don't trust him, those are things that you want possibly some short-term supportive therapy for. Or you could get the book Mind Over Mood by Dennis Greenberger and Christine Padetsky. They have a wonderful exercise that has helped me through such difficult times. And it's called a thought record, where if your thoughts are running away and making you enormously sad, like there's no sunshine at the other end, it can help you see which thoughts are realistic and you need to accept, and which are maybe off the wall. You know, they may have some facts or maybe no facts at all. So what else can you do? Well, you want to stay connected with him. You love him. So you can send each other quick, funny texts throughout the day, or little emojis. You can keep in touch with him by phone, by email. You can ask for his suggestions. You know, ask him what he thinks you could do to stay really closely bonded. And you could ask him short stories about his day and share stories about your day. And maybe you can even travel with him at some point. It may be just once, or just to get a feel for his life. So another thing I thought of is that possibly you could plan things during the weekend so you have something to look forward to. He will be home on weekends. Another point is that you can remember times when you were very resourceful. You came across some bumps in the road and you were able to manage them well. This is a bump in the road. It's a very difficult bump for your marriage. If you can draw on your own personal strengths, that helps. And finally, I would say, build a life filled with things that you enjoy. So think of what hobbies or classes or exercise endeavors might I love that would make me excited to get up in the morning. Maybe I want to connect with a friend I haven't seen in a while. And you can look at it as an opportunity to create a little wider scope of living for yourself, since he won't be around, and you'll also have some stories to share with him. So again, you want to have a lot of empathy for yourself, mourn the loss of what your relationship was like. You want to be able to, in some sense, cheer him on, because he's got a job he loves. If you don't have a job you love, maybe it's an unmet need of yours that you want to go back to the drawing board and see if you can find something that you would love too. But you want to create a day for yourself, each day of the week, the weekdays of what you're looking at, that make you want to take on the day, that have something fun in them. And I hope that helps you. I'm Dr. Ellen Kenner on the Rational Basis of Happiness. My number's toll-free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. That's toll-free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. I'm a clinical psychologist here to take your calls and questions. And again, my show is The Rational Basis of Happiness, and that means your happiness matters. You don't want to give it up. You don't want to say, oh, I feel I'm too selfish, because you want to value yourself. You don't want to put yourself down. You want to seriously value yourself. You don't want to brush off your feelings. So if you're having strong feelings like this caller had, you want to process your feelings. You don't want to try to talk yourself out of them and shame yourself for having feelings. Again, I'm Dr. Ellen Kenner on the Rational Basis of Happiness. You can call me toll-free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. That's toll-free, 1-877-DR-KENNER. That's toll-free, 1-877-DR-KENNER.
Here's an excerpt from The Selfish Path to Romance by clinical psychologist Dr. Ellen Kenner.
Love is an emotion, and all emotions have consciously identifiable causes. But certain factors make the causes of emotions, such as love, joy, and sadness, especially difficult to identify. Emotions occur automatically and instantly, based on how we appraise people or situations. Emotions don't develop in slow motion. You catch your boyfriend in bed with your best friend, and you are instantly flooded with anger. You reunite with your husband after he's returned from his military tour of duty, and you immediately feel overjoyed. The appraisals causing our emotions are not only automatic, but also subconscious, outside of our immediate awareness. You feel irritated with your wife, but may not be able to easily put into words what's specifically causing your irritation.
You can download Chapter 1 for free at drkenner.com, and you can buy the book at amazon.com.